Hi guys, welcome to Jubi Tips, and in today's tutorial I'm going to be showing you how to make curved rectangles in PowerPoint. We'll be making this classic four corner curves rectangle, and then the two corner curved rectangle, and then finding the one curved rectangle. And by the way, I'm using PowerPoint 2016, but this should work on any earlier or later versions of PowerPoint because the principles are quite the same. So let's get started. I have created a new slide. Let's copy one of the shape here, Control C. Here, Control V. By the way, Control V will always paste in the same location. So if you want to keep the format of your the structure of your slide the same, Control V on the new slide would work. We would grab this. Let's go to Shape Format. It's under the Drawing Tool, kind of gray shading here. We're going to go to Edit Shape, and we're going to go to Change Shape, and then we're choosing the second option in the Rectangles area, and it's going to be Rectangle Rounded Corners. Okay, so this is what you have. So let me undo that. Move this on the left side. By the way, so I'm going to use Control Shift and then drag. This is going to keep the shape on the same line and make a copy. Very, very useful. Control Z to undo to show you again. Control Shift, drag. Okay. With this shape selected, this I'm going to repeat my action. Edit Shape, Change Shape, and then choose a second option: Rectangle Round Corners. So we're done. The next example, this second corner curve is going to be a little bit more difficult. We're going to grab this shape once again. Control Shift down. Okay, to create a copy, and I'm going to Control Shift this guy once again to create a new copy. Okay, just I'm going to be having two copies. The first copy I'm going to make it rounded corner just like before. So shape format, edit shape, change shape, and then rounded corners. The second shape, the first thing I'm going to do is change it into a different color so that I can, you know, distinguish the first one. I'm going to drag it by shift drag. This is going to keep it in the same alignment, not moving out of the grid, but it won't make a copy. It will just move. Okay, shift drag. And you see how the grid kind of locks in together. It means it's in the right place. I'm going to release. Okay, so the shape now are on top of each other. But the shape is hiding this shape. This yellow shape is hiding the grayish blue shape under it. So I'm going to go to home and select. And I'm going to choose selection pane. And by the way, by clicking that selection pane, this area will show up. Okay, so it's already here. So I'm just going to show you again selection pane. And it's going to show you all of the objects on this slide. It works very similar to Photoshop. And you can see this one, this is background is on top. I'm just going to drag it all the way to the bottom, okay? So that it's, you know, the last thing on this slide, and everything else will be on top. So you can clearly see the two shapes here. All right. So we are going to now select both of the shapes, go to Shape Format, and we're going to go to Merge Shapes and find the Union. Okay. Oh, oops, sorry. One thing I forgot to do. I'm going to grab this shape here, which is the rectangle, and I'm going to hold Shift on my keyboard and drag the top border down just a teeny bit. Okay? And now I'm going to do what I just showed you. So select everything, and I'm going to go to Shape Format, Merge Shape, and then we're going to go to Union. Okay? Perfect. Let's undo that. Make a copy because we're going to need this for the next task. We're going to Control Shift drag to the right side again. Lock it in place, and let's do this again. So let's try keyboard shortcut. So Alt, and you can go to JD, right? This is also a keyboard shortcut, and SH, sorry, JD, SHM, sorry, let's see here, do I have, oh, maybe this board. And let's go to Union, so that's done, okay? And for this last one, one corner, this is gonna be a little bit more tricky. I need to kind of cover this area here. You see how it's having some stuff there, so I'm just gonna grab this background one, which is the yellow thing that's under. No, maybe that's not it. Not this one. Not this one. This is the one. I'm going to hold Shift and I'm going to drag it out just a little bit. But you see how it's selecting both this background and the background above. So I'm just going to undo the Control Z. I'm going to hide this top layer momentarily. Just keep this at the bottom layer. I'm just going to do Control Shift drag to create a copy and keep in line the same grid. Now I'm going to unhide this so it comes back. Drag this guy back so that it locks in grid again. I'm gonna drag the top border up. I'm gonna drag the left border to the right side. Now everything is in place. I'm gonna select everything once again. Shape format, merge shape, in union. And then you go. We have all of the four shapes that we need. If you have any questions about this, please leave me comments. I'll be happy to answer them for you. By the way, you can change the color here. There's